Hello and welcome to another used car video from TW White & Sons Mazda. Today I'm going to be showing you this Mazda 3. This car is the Sport Lux specification. It is an automatic petrol car. Exterior colour on this vehicle is the polymetal grey with the interior of the black cloth. What I'll do is I'll take you around the vehicle and tell you a bit about it, show you the condition, and then we'll go and have a look on the inside as well. This car is a one owner vehicle, does have full Mazda service history. It was first registered in November 2019 on a 69 plate, as you can see. Prior to leaving us, we will be MOTing and servicing the vehicle. But as you can see, this car is in great condition. Barely a mark on it from what I can see. All the alloys in perfect condition. What I'll do is I'll start the rear, have a look in the boot. Really good size, practical boot. You've got your 60-40 splitting rear seats. This car does have front and rear parking sensors, as well as a reverse camera. This car also has the privacy glass on the rear doors and windscreen again, which is a nice feature. As I mentioned, this car's got the cloth interior with Isofix fittings on both sides. You've also got a central armrest with two cup holders for the rear passengers, which is nice. Coming into the front of the vehicle, you have got the blind spot monitoring. You see that triangle just there, it'll focus. That will light up orange if there is a car in your blind spot. On the door here, we've got your electric mirror adjustment with power fold function. We've also got electric windows all round. Again, conditioning the front, really nice. No marks or anything from what I can see. As you come in the vehicle, you've got a set of buttons here, which is kind of your features you can turn off. So you've got your iStop, stop, start technology, which if you're not a fan, you can turn that off. You've got your traction control, and you've also got your parking sensors, which you can turn on if you'd like, and off. Obviously, they will come on when you go into reverse. Coming into the vehicle, you've got your fuel gauge and temperature gauge, analog on the right side, and then you've got an analog rev counter on the left side. You can have, if you press this info button here, the central speedo as just analog, but you can also have different displays depending on what your preference is. On the left-hand stalk, you've got your auto lights, and on the right-hand side, you've got your automatic windscreen wipers. Coming onto the steering wheel, on the right-hand side, you've got your cruise control, which is adaptive, so you can set it to vehicle in front of you. You can choose the distance, and then as that vehicle slows down, this car will also do the same. On the right-hand side, you've got your volume controls, your change track or song function. Just below that, you've got your Bluetooth controls for answering and declining calls, and obviously the info button, which I just mentioned. As I mentioned before, this car is an automatic, so you have got paddles either side if you did want to put the car into manual. You've got your infotainment screen in the centre there. Just below that, you've got your climate control, which you can turn on and off by pressing this button. And you can adjust the fan speed, and obviously you can put the AC on and off. Then you've got your heated windscreens either side, and then you've got your heated seats on a three-stage function. Just below that, you've got a CD player with a USB socket. Got storage there at the back where I put the keys for the moment, and you've also got another two cup holders which you can hide away. Here I've got a sport button next to the gear shifter, which you can flick on and off. If I pop the car by pressing the brake into reverse, you see that rear camera, nice clear picture, and you've also got the visual display there as well. Slightly further back then, you've got all your controls for your infotainment. Starting from the left, so you've got the volume controls, which you can turn up and down. You can push down to mute, and you can also use it as a joystick to kind of change songs either way. Just below that, you've got a star, which you can set up or configure to a favorites button, essentially. So whatever you want an easy shortcut to be, you can configure that. You've got buttons all around here. So top left, you've got your shortcut to your music. Top right, you've got your shortcut to your sat nav, and then bottom left, you do have a home button, and bottom right, you've just got a back button. Further on to the right, you've got your electric handbrake. So with the foot on the brake and pushing that down, that's your handbrake off. And then again, you can flick it up to bring the handbrake back on. And then you've also got your auto hold function. If you're on a hill, the car will hold until you accelerate, and then you can move away. Slightly further back, you do have a nice deep storage cubby. Again, with another USB socket and a 12 volt socket as well. Going back to the infotainment screen then, if you press home, this is what your home display looks like. You've got a couple of options here. We'll start from the top. Same information, you've got your fuel efficiency monitor, so you can kind of see how the car's performing, what your MPG is. You've also got your vehicle status monitor, which will tell you when the car's due for a service intervals, that sort of thing. Next, you've got your infotainment. So you've always got your DAB, FM and AM radio. You can also listen to your own music as well via Bluetooth, which brings me on to the next one, which is where you can obviously connect your phone to accept calls and whatnot. Next then, we've got the Mazda satellite navigation, which is really nice, easy system to use. And then lastly, you've got settings. So again, you can configure the car to how you'd like it to be. So you've got sound settings, safety settings, vehicle settings. You can just make adjustments to your personal preference. And there we go. What I'll do then, I'll put the vehicle off just by pressing that button. And I'll finish up on the outside. This car will come with a year's warranty, which includes roadside assistance as well. If you're interested in this vehicle, please do drop us a call or an email. Alternatively, you can inquire via the website that you're viewing this vehicle on. We can obviously discuss finance and delivery of the vehicle. And we can also discuss part exchange, as we do accept all cars in part exchange. Hope you enjoyed this video. Have a lovely day.